Hello and welcome back to MechZone. In the previous lectures, we were solving problems related to thermodynamics, and we have already covered about 5 lectures, and we have covered say around 120 problems so far. There are 300 problems in total in this complete course of thermodynamics, and some more problems, say about 70 to 80 problems, will be there from the chapters of thermodynamic relationships and pure substances की प्रॉपर्टीज के ऊपर होंगे. तो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस लेक्चर आई वुड सिंपली लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू दैट इफ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब्ड टू आवर चैनल येट, काइंडली डू सो बाय हिटिंग द सब्सक्रिप्शन बटन और बेल आइकन को भी जल्दी से प्रेस कर लीजिए सो दैट ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट अपडेट्स आपके पास जितना जल्दी हो सके पहुंच जाए. आप हमारे चैनल से हमारे नोट्स भी खरीद सकते हैं www.megzone.co.in पर जाकर, और आप हमारा एक डिस्काउंट कोड है MZ3733, कैपिटल M कैपिटल Z3733, उसको यूज़ करके आप हमारे कोर्सेज पर एक्साइटिंग डिस्काउंट्स भी अवेल कर सकते हैं. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम ऑफ दिस डे, एंड इट हैज़ बीन गिवन दैट अ मोनो अटोमिक आइडियल गैस हैविंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एडियाबैटिक इंडेक्स गामा एज 1.67 मोल 1.67 and molecular weight has been given as 40 is compressed adiabatically from 0.1 megapascal 300 Kelvin to 0.2 megapascal. The universal gas constant, that is R bar, has been given as 8.314 kilojoule per mole per Kelvin. The work of compression would be, now we need to find out the work of compression, and the formula for W is nothing but P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon gamma minus 1. This would be the work of compression. Now using the gas equation PV is equals to MRT, we will write P1 V1 as MRT1 minus MRT2 divided by gamma minus 1. Now we don't know what is the value of T2. So in order to find out the value of T2, we will use this relation T2 upon T1 is equals to P2 upon P1 to the power of gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Now we know the value of T1, and it has been given to us already. So value of T2 would be nothing, T1 multiplied by P2 upon P1 to the power of gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Now the value of T1 would be 300 Kelvin. Okay, so the value of T2 which is coming out here is 396.18 Kelvin. Now by using the relationship, that is T1 minus MRT2 upon gamma minus 1. So we can take MR as common upon gamma minus 1, and we have T1 minus T2. So the value of R can be evaluated as R bar upon the molecular weight. So here we will have the value of mass. M will be taken as 1 because it has not been given in the question, so it will be assumed as 1, and we can calculate the value of mass also. P1 V1 is equals to MRT1. So यहाँ से हमें मास की भी वैल्यू निकल सकती है. तो जो मास की वैल्यू हमें ऑप्टेन हो रही है, जस्ट अ सेकेंड, ओके. तो यहाँ पर जो हमें मास की वैल्यू है, एक्चुअली वो हमें 1 ही लेनी पड़ेगी. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ मास विल बी टेकन हियर एज 1. सो एम वुड बी टेकन एज 1, एंड वी हैव ऑब्टेन्ड T2 एज 396.18 केल्विन, एंड बाय यूजिंग द फॉर्मूला MR अपॉन गामा माइनस 1 T1 minus T2. This would be the amount of work done. So M is taken as 1. R would be R bar upon molecular weight. So 8.314 divided by molecular weight, which is 40, multiplied by 1 upon gamma minus 1. Gamma is 1.67 minus 1. And T1 minus T2. T1 is 300 Kelvin minus T2 is 396.18 Kelvin. So the value of work done is coming out to be minus 29.78 kilojoules per kg. Now the work done is coming out to be negative because here compression process is taking place, and when compression is taking place, the work would be done on the system. Okay, now let us solve the next question which has been given to us. And in this question we have given a nitrogen gas of molecular weight 28 is enclosed in a cylinder piston at the initial condition this much. In a particular process the gas slowly expands under the isothermal condition. Please note we have been given isothermal expansion until the volume becomes 2 meter cube. The work interaction would be, now M molecular weight has been given as 28, P initial has been given as 2 bar, T initial has been given as 298 Kelvin, volume initial has been given as 1 meter cube, and volume final is becoming 2 meter cube. Now we know that the work interaction for isothermal process is P1 V1 ln V2 upon V1. So P1 would be 2 bar or 200 kilopascal multiplied by 1 ln 2 upon 1. So the work interaction is coming out to be 138.629 kilojoule per kg. So this is the answer. Now in the next question, it is also a very important question with regards to gate. So in this question we have been given 1.5 kg of water is in saturated liquid state at 2 bar. Specific volume of saturated liquid has been given, and internal energy of the saturated liquid has been given, and enthalpy of the saturated liquid has been given. Heat is added in a constant pressure process till the temperature of water reaches 400 degrees C. Specific volume has been given, specific internal energy has been given, and enthalpy has also been given. Now the amount of heat which is added in the process. Now we can see that the terms like specific volume, internal energy, and heat are coming in this particular question. So we will write down the equation which is involving all these three terms, and that is the first law of thermodynamics. So in the first law of thermodynamics, we can write it as dq would be equals to du plus pdv. Now dq would be u2 minus u1 plus pv2 minus v1. Okay, now we will keep the values of u2 is this much, u1 is this much. Pressure P has been given as 2 bar, which would be kept as 200 kilopascal. V2 has been given as 1.5493. V1 has been given as 0.001061. So keeping all these values here, the value of DQ is coming out to be 2772.6478 kilojoules per kg. Now but the mass of water that has been given to us is 1.5 kg. So for 1.5 kg of water, the heat interaction would be 2772.6478 multiplied by 1.5. This is coming out to be 4158.97 kilojoules. So this is the answer. Now in the next question, we have this question which is related to the steady flow energy equation, and let us try to solve this question. So we have been given work is done on the adiabatic system due to which its velocity changes from 10 meters per second to 20 meters per second. Elevation is increasing by 20 meters and the temperature increases by 1 Kelvin. The mass of the system is 10 kg. CV has been given as 100 joule per kg Kelvin, and the gravitational constant, that is small g, has been given as 10 meter per second square. Now I will tell you some very basic facts about g. If this is the earth, this is the equator, this is the north pole, this is the south pole, and this is the center of the earth. Say this is the center. So the value of g is maximum at the poles and it is minimum at the equator, and it is zero at the center of the earth. So there was a question in the PSU which was asked, and the interview asked the person that if a person is traveling from Moscow to India, he finds that he has lost his way. What can you expect the exact reason? So the reason was, when the person is traveling from Moscow to India, then he is traveling from North Pole towards the equator. So there would be some decrease in the value of G. And since W is equals to mg, mass is always generally constant, G, the value of G is changing. So value of G decreases as he moves from Moscow to India, and therefore he loses weight. But the person replied that kyunki tabiyat kharab ho gayi hogi ya ulti ho gayi hogi, is type ka kuch tha. To is wajah se ye answer unka galat maan liya gaya tha. तो ये सब बातें हैं जो हमें ध्यान रखनी पड़ती हैं कि इंटरव्यू में कई बार ऐसे बहुत बेसिक क्वेश्चन पूछ लेते हैं जो नाइन्थ और टेंथ क्लास के लेवल के भी हो सकते हैं. तो यहाँ पर हमें जो भी डेटा दिया हुआ है एडियाबैटिक प्रोसेस के लिए, तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे, अपनी स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन को लिखेंगे. और स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन को लिखने के बाद फिर हम लोग यहाँ पर अपना सल्यूशन करेंगे. सो डेल क्यू वुड बी इक्वल्स टू डी यू प्लस डी के ई प्लस डी पी ई प्लस डी डब्ल्यू. तो एडियाबैटिक प्रोसेस के लिए ये हमारा जीरो हो गया. डी यू कितना होता है, एम सी वी डी टी प्लस ये कितना हो जाएगा, हाफ एम वी टू स्क्वेयर माइनस वी वन स्क्वेयर प्लस ये क्या हो जाएगा, एम जी जेड वन माइनस जेड टू प्लस डेल्टा W. So keeping the values of V2, V1, Z1 minus Z2 and keeping the value of M as 10, G as M as 10, G as 10. So when you will solve it, you will get delta W is coming out to be minus 4.5 kilo joule. Now since it is said that the work is done on the adiabatic system, so work done on the system would be represented with a minus or the negative sign. So this is the answer to this question. Okay, now let us do the next question. And here we have been given an inlet and the outlet conditions of the steam for the adiabatic steam turbine are given as follows. These are the inlet conditions and these are the outlet conditions. The inlet conditions are generally given with the sign or taken with 1, and outlet conditions are given with 2. Okay, so if the mass flow rate of the steam, that is m dot, has been given as 20 kg per second, what would be the power output of the turbine? So power output is nothing but the work done that we have to find out. So let us write down the steady flow energy equation, m1 dot h1 plus v1 square upon 2000 plus gz1 upon 1000 plus del q would be equals to m dot h2 plus v2 square upon 2000 plus gz2 upon 1000 plus delta w. So we will keep the values of the inlet and the outlet, and we will find that delta W would be nothing but mass flow rate has been given as 20. So H1, ye wala jo portion hai pura hum yahan pe le aayenge left pe, to H1 minus H2, it would be 3200 minus 16, sorry, 2600 plus velocity here is 160 and here is how much, 100. So it would be 160 square minus 100 square upon 2000 plus g, the value of g let us take it as 10, z1 minus z2, z1 has been given as 10 and z2 has been given as 6, so 10 minus 6 upon 1000. And since it is adiabatic, so this would be zero. So after solving this, delta W is coming out to be 12.157 megawatts. So this would be the power output of the turbine, 12.175 megawatts. वॉट, 157 मेगावाट। तो ये बहुत ही सिंपल क्वेश्चन है जो डायरेक्टली आपका बेस्ड है स्टेडी फ्लो एनर्जी इक्वेशन पर। Now let us do the next question, and in this next question we have to prove an identity. An insulated pressure cylinder of volume V has been given, contains air at a pressure P naught and the temperature T naught. It is to be filled from a compressor and the temperature compressor air line maintained at a constant pressure P1 and the temperature T1. Show that the temperature of the air in this cylinder after it has been charged with the pressure of air line is given by this much. So let us first draw the diagram for this particular question. So I hope the lectures that are available on MechZone are quite understandable to you all, and you all are enjoying studying mechanical engineering from our channel. So we would like to request you that if you have your friends in different colleges, try to convey to them that there is a channel which is providing free of cost education, and notes are also available. You can buy the notes from our website. Okay, now what we have is let us try to write down the conditions. That this is the diagram that is there. Okay, so we have UF minus UI would be equals to M entering into HI. Okay, M entering into HI. This is the condition that we have already seen. But before that condition, there is one more condition, that is delta U of the control volume should be equal to energy which is entering minus energy which is exit. Now energy exit would be zero since no mass is leaving this system, and energy entering would be M2 minus M1 into H I. Okay, 2 I am representing for the final condition and 1 I am representing for the initial condition. Now we have UF minus UI would be equals to M entering into H I, or this is nothing but M final minus M initial into H I. So we have MF CV TF minus MI CV TI. This would be equals to MF minus M in multiplied by CP into T I n. Now let us take CV as common, and we can obtain P1 V by R minus P0 V by R. This would be equals to P1 V upon RT minus P0 V upon RT naught. Okay, we are simply substituting the values multiplied by CP into T IN, that is T1. Now I have to erase a certain portion. Now let me do it. This facility is very good that we have digital pen technology, pen tablet technology, which is making education to be very, very simple. I only have to select the appropriate option and erase the data which is extraneous or which is extra here. Okay, so P1 minus P0 would be equals to P1 upon T minus P0 upon T0 into gamma times T1. CP is gamma. CP को हम लोगों ने क्या लिखा है? CP upon CV कर दिया था वहां से, तो वो आ गया gamma times T1 आ गया था. CV को हम लोगों ने left से हटा के right में divide कर दिया था. So P1 minus P0 plus gamma times T1 P0. This would be, upon T naught, this would be equals to gamma times T1
p1 upon t, okay? And तो यहाँ से अगर आप t की वैल्यू निकालें, so it would be gamma times t1 p1 divided by p1 minus p0 plus gamma times t1 p0 upon t0. So this is nothing but gamma times t1 p1 p1 plus p0 gamma times t1 upon t0 minus. So hence the identity is proved. So I would not recommend this type of question, you to practice this type of question. This was just to give you a glimpse of tough questions. एक थोड़ा tough question पड़ जाता है proving का, तो इतना ऐसे tough generally नहीं पूछा जाता. तो I would not like to recommend such type of questions to be practiced for any competitive examination. Okay. Now the next question that we have, question number 127. So we have been given that in a cyclic process heat transfer has been given as plus 15.7, minus 26.2, minus 4.86 and 31.5. What is the net work transfer? Now we know according to the first law of thermodynamics, we have the cyclic integral of the heat transfer would be equal to the cyclic integral of the work transfer. So the work transfer would be nothing but 15.7 minus 26.2 minus 4.86 plus 31.5. So the answer is coming out to be 16.41 kilojoule. So the correct option is option number B. Now let us look at the question number 128. It is also a simple question. A stationary mass of gas is compressed without friction from initial state itna itna to final state itna. The pressure remaining constant during the process, there is a transfer of itna kilojoule of heat from the gas during the process. What is the change in the internal energy? Now again we will apply delta Q is equals to du plus del W. So Q from 1 to 2 would be equals to U2 minus U1 plus W from 1 to 2. So W from 1 to 2 would be nothing but integral 1 to 2 P dV, or you can write it as P V2 minus V1. So this would be pressure is .15 minus 0.3. This is coming out to be just a second. Actually, this pressure, yeah, it has been given as 1 megapascal, not 0.1. So this would be coming out to be minus 15 kilojoule. So Q12 would be equals to minus 40 kilojoule, because work ki value aa chuki hai, aur one second, itna ye to itna diya hi hua hai, to minus 40 hum logo ne isko likh lenge. To ab is wali equation mein hum log work ki value put karenge minus 15 aur Q ki value put karenge minus 40. So the answer for delta U is coming out to be minus 25 kilojoule. So this is very simple and important question, and this can be asked in SSC JEE. Okay, so now let us look at the next question. An engine is tested by means of water break. Okay, so delta Q, water break at 1000 rpm, the measured torque of the engine is 10 ke baad 30 mn newton meter, and the water consumption of the brake is 0.5 meter cube per second. Its inlet temperature is being 25 degree centigrade. Assuming that the whole of the engine power is ultimately transferred to the heat which is absorbed by the cooling water, what is the water exit temperature of the water at exit? So we will first try to find out what is the engine power. The engine power is 2 pi nt upon 60. So if you keep the values, it is coming out to be 1046.67 watt. Okay, now we know that Q is equals to mc delta t. This would be nothing but the power which is by the engine. So now using the proper units, we will be using the proper units. So it would be 0.5, because m has been given as 0.5. c will be taken as 4.2 into 1000 multiplied by delta t. This would be equals to 1046.67 watt. मतलब होता है joule per second. इसीलिए हमने यहाँ पर इसे joule में ले लिया है, kilo joule की वजह से. तो यहाँ पर delta t जो हमारा आएगा, it is coming out to be 0.5 degree centigrade. ठीक है, तो ये 0.5 degree centigrade से obviously हमारा जो टेम्परेचर है अब वो वेरी कर जाएगा. तो आंसर, इनिशियल टेम्परेचर हमारा 25 था, अब हमारा फाइनल टेम्परेचर 0.5 से घट जाएगा. तो जो अब टेम्परेचर हमारा बचेगा एग्जिट वाटर का, इट वुड बी 25, जस्ट अ सेकेंड, द एग्जिट टेम्परेचर ऑफ द इंजन. Let me check the question. I think there is some data which I have missed or something like that. तो कभी कभी questions में कुछ data रह जाता है जो कि हमें बहुत अच्छे से देखना पड़ता है, क्योंकि कोई भी data अगर plus minus या कोई भी एक ऐसा बहुत silly सी mistake हो गई तो हमारा question उसकी वजह से गलत भी हो सकता है. तो इन चीज़ों का हमें बहुत ध्यान रखना पड़ता है. और जैसा कि हमारे, आप देख सकते हैं चैनल को 1000 सब्सक्राइबर्स जब हुए थे तो हम लोगों ने एक्सपेक्ट नहीं किया था कि इतना जल्दी चैनल हमारा ग्रो करेगा. और एंड करेंटली वी आर एट 20,000 सब्सक्राइबर्स भी हमारे क्रॉस हो गए हैं. सो वी वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू ऑल फॉर दिस लव एंड सपोर्ट दैट यू हैव शोन अस, एंड कीप शोइंग दिस लव टूवर्ड्स अस, एंड वी विल बी वेटिंग for the 50,000 subscribers jis din honge. So we will be introducing a lot more on this channel. So just a second. Yes, the temperature, that is delta T, is coming out to be plus 0.5. that means the temperature would be raised by 20 sorry it would be raised by 0.5 degree. So the answer will be 25 plus 0.5, that is 25.5 degree centigrade. So the answer is option number D. Okay, now let us do another question, and before attempting that question I need to erase this data. Okay, and let us read this question. The polytropic process is represented by a straight line in the following figure. What is x and y respectively? Now we need to find out what are x and y in the given question. Okay, now since it is a polytropic process, that means PV to the power of n would be a constant. Now we will take ln on both the sides, so we have ln P plus n ln V would be equals to ln C, and logarithm of the constant let us say at C. Okay, so we will write it as ln P plus n ln V would be simply equals to C. So this is nothing but it is representing the equation of a straight line. This represents the equation of a straight line, and let us name it as Y plus n x is equals to c, where y plus mx is equals to c, where n is the slope. So we can also rewrite this equation as y upon c plus x upon c by n. This would be equals to 1. So from the option itself we can see that the correct pair would be ln p and ln v. ओके, तो यहाँ पर जो हमारा करेक्ट ऑप्शन है वो है ऑप्शन नंबर सी. ओके, तो ये था हमारा ऑप्शन नंबर सी विल बी करेक्ट. नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन 131, द परपेचुअल मोशन मशीन वन इज अ हाइपोथेटिकल मशीन हुज ऑपरेशन वुड वायलेट द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर डी. नाउ फॉर 132, what is the temperature rise after 5 minutes in the given below volume. So we know that the total energy which is going inside the system would be the total energy which would be coming outside the system. That means we will have the energy balance. Now for this 10 newton meter revolving at 100 radians per second, so we have for 5 minutes it would be 10 into 100 into 5 into 60. This would be the total energy going in, okay, and the total energy coming out plus the total energy coming out would be 10 into 50 into 5 into 60, which would be because of this electrical heating. So the energy going out would be, this is the total energy going in, because यहाँ पे electrical heating भी हो रही है और ये work done भी किया जा रहा है, तो उसके कारण ही जो total energy इसमें input होगी ये हमारी हो जाएगी 450 kilojoule. Now energy in would be equals to energy out, and energy in energy out, this is would be equals to mcp delta t. So 450 would be equals to mcp delta t. So delta t would be 450 upon m into cp. So this would be 450 divided by 2 into 1.005, because 2 has been given as the mass of air. So delta t is coming out to be 502.5 kilojoule. Just a second. Oh, I'm so sorry. This is coming out to be, it's not 502. This 450 divided by 2 into 1.05 is nearly coming out to be 223.88 degree centigrade. So the answer would be 224 degree centigrade. So here what we are doing is, we are simply evaluating or we are equating the energy which will be going out would be energy which would be entering in. Now the input sources are two. One is the work done which is done, work which is being done on this gas, and the second one is the electrical energy which is being supplied to this gas. So the total energy would be 450. This 450 would be equals to mcp dt, and we will calculate the value of dt or delta t from this equation. Now the next question is, energy added to 5 kg of air with a paddle wheel till delta t is equals to 100 degrees centigrade. What is the paddle wheel work if the rigid volume is insulated? Now we have been asked about what is the paddle wheel work if the rigid volume is insulated. Now if the rigid is insulated, that is the rigid volume is insulated, we can write delta q is equals to du plus del w. Okay, now for the insulation we have, this is equals to zero, so delta w would be equals to mcp dt. Okay, it would be equals to mcp dt. So mass has been given as 5, cp is 1.005, dt is 100, so this is coming out to be 502.5 kilojoule, which is not matching in any of these cases. So correct answer jo hamara hai 502.5 kilojoules hi hai jo ki yahan. Okay, तो यहाँ पर जो करेक्ट आंसर है वो है 502.5 किलो जूल्स. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज,
the value of heat and work transfer for the flow process of thermodynamic cycles are given below. Now the thermal efficiency and the work ratio will be respectively. Here we have to find out the thermal efficiency and the work ratio. Okay, now in order to find that, we will first find the efficiency, and for efficiency we already know efficiency is equals to W upon Q added. So this would be nothing but 300, just a second, it would be 300 plus 250 minus 100 minus 250 divided by Q supplied would be 300. So efficiency is coming out to be 66.66%. okay, so efficiency only ek hi mein sahi di hui hai, thermal efficiency 66%. So the correct answer is option number B. Next is, according to the first law of thermodynamics, the total internal energy of the system during the process remains constant. Total energy of the system remains constant, or total work done by the system is equal to the total heat transferred by the system. The internal energy enthalpy, ye to ho hi nahi sakta. The total internal energy, ye ho nahi sakta. Work done by the system is equal to the heat transferred by the system, ye bhi sahi nahi hai. Lekin sahi answer hai, the total energy of the system is remaining constant. So ye ho jayega aapka sahi option. Next is, internal energy is defined by, now the internal energy is defined by the first law of thermodynamics, that is del Q is equals to du plus del W. So ye du ka jo funda hai wo hamara yahi se aaya hai. Next is, key concept in analyzing the filling of an evacuated tank is, the correct answer is option number B, the enthalpy of the valve, enthalpy across the valve is remaining constant. Now the next question that we have, the first law of thermodynamics is valid for, now it is valid for all types of processes, whether reversible or irreversible. Ye ho gaya hamara. During a thermodynamic process, 84 kilojoule of heat flows into the system and the work done by the system is 32 kilojoule. The increase in the internal energy would be, now we know that delta Q is equals to du plus del W. Now keeping the values with their appropriate sign, we have 84 is equals to du plus 32. So du is nothing but 52 kilojoule. So the answer is option number A. Okay, answer is coming out to be option number A. Now let us do the next question, and in the next question is, the specific heat at constant pressure for the ideal gas is given by Cp is equals to 0.9 plus 2.7 into 10 to the power minus 4 T, where T is in Kelvin. The change in the enthalpy for this ideal gas undergoing a process in which the temperature changes from 27 degree centigrade to 127 degree centigrade is mostly. So we know that dH is equals to mCp dT. Now if we integrate both the sides and put the appropriate limits, here the limit will vary from 27 to 127 degree centigrade, that is from 300 Kelvin to 400 Kelvin. So we can write it as, from 300 to 400, this would be 0.9 plus 2.7 into 10 to the power minus 4 T dT. Now on integration we will find it as 0.9 T plus 2.7 into 10 to the power minus 4 T square by 2, and the limits would be from 300 to 400. Now the answer that will be obtained is 99.45 kilojoule per kg. So the correct answer here is option number C.
Now the next question, in a reversible isothermal expansion process, fluid expands from 10 bar 2 meter cube to 2 bar and 10 meter cube. During the process, the heat supplied at the rate of 100 kilowatt. What is the rate of work done during the process? Now this is a very simple question. Del Q is equals to du plus del W. So here we know that dq would be equals to del W, and du would be zero because it is an isothermal process, and du is equals to mcv dt. Here dt is zero, so here it would be equals to 100 kilowatt. That means del Q would be equals to del W. So the option is 100 kilowatt. Aap is pe na jaye, yahan par ye na dekhe, ye aise hi lag chuka hai by mistake. So correct answer is 100 kilowatt. Now the next question that we have is, the state of an ideal gas is changed from T1 P1 to T2 P2 in a constant volume process. To calculate the change in enthalpy, all of the following properties variables are required. Now we have to find which one is actually required. Now we know that dh is equals to mcp dt. Now if we look very carefully, the requirement of only cp and temperatures is necessary in order to find out h. So the correct option would be option number b. Correct option is option number B, because we require only Cp, T1 and T2 in order to find the change in enthalpy. Now the next question that we have, question number 143, and the question says, for the two paths as shown in the figure, one is reversible and the other one is irreversible. To change the state of the system from A to B, delta U, Q, W are same. Delta U is same. Q and W are same. Delta U and Q are different. Now, it is a very obvious question that delta U would be same because it is a point function and it is independent of the path whichever is being followed. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पर correct option हो जाएगा हमारा, delta U is same. Now the next question, consider the following statements about the steady flow process and steady flow process के बारे में कुछ statements हमें दिए गए हैं. तो यहाँ पर पहला स्टेटमेंट जो है, द रेट ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ मास एनर्जी अक्रॉस द कंट्रोल सरफेस इज कांस्टेंट. दूसरा, थर्मोडायनेमिक प्रॉपर्टीज वेरी अलोंग स्पेस एज वेल एज टाइम कोऑर्डिनेट्स. तीसरा जो है, अ थर्मोडायनेमिक प्रॉपर्टी विल हैव अ फिक्स्ड वैल्यू एट अ पर्टिकुलर लोकेशन एंड विल नॉट ऑल्टर विद टाइम. नाउ विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आर करेक्ट. अब यहाँ पर इसमें से कौन सा हमारा जो पॉइंट है वो करेक्ट है. तो अगर हम देखें वन वाला, द रेट ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ मास एनर्जी अक्रॉस द कंट्रोल वॉल्यूम, ये हमारा डेफिनेटली कांस्टेंट होता है स्टेडी फ्लो प्रोसेस में. अच्छा, अगर हम टू को देखें तो टू स्टेटमेंट हमारा ट्रू नहीं है बिकॉज थर्मोडायनेमिक प्रॉपर्टीज वेरी नहीं करती, और थर्ड वाला हमारा सही है. तो जो करेक्ट ऑप्शन है इज ऑप्शन नंबर बी. Next is, consider the following comparative points of SFEE, that is steady flow energy equation, with Bernoulli's equation. These two have several terms in common. Both Bernoulli equation and steady flow energy equation is valid for viscous compressible fluids. The Bernoulli's equation is a special limiting case of SFEE. Now out of the three, which one is correct? So one is actually correct because they are having several terms in common. एक तो velocity head वाला term आ जाता है और ऊपर से gravitational head वाला term भी हमारा common हो जाता है. अगर हम two को देखें, both Bernoulli's equation and steady flow energy equation is valid for viscous compressible. ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है, viscous compressible के लिए दोनों applicable नहीं होते. ठीक है, Bernoulli's equation is valid for frictionless incompressible fluids, whereas SFEE is valid for viscous compressible fluids. तो हमारी Bernoulli's equation viscous के लिए नहीं apply होती, rather वो हमारे frictionless incompressible के लिए use होती है. Third वाला use करें, third वाला देखें, तो Bernoulli's equation is definitely a limiting case of SFEE. So the correct option would be option number
बी हो जाएगा हमारा करेक्ट. सो द नेक्स्ट ऑप्शन दैट इज सॉरी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन लेट इज लुक एट निगलेक्टिंग चेंजेस इन द काइनेटिक एंड द पोटेंशियल एनर्जीज द आइडेंटिटी इंटीग्रल माइनस 1 to 2 वी डी पी इज इक्वल टू एच वन माइनस एच टू फॉर शाफ्ट वर्क ड्यूरिंग अ स्टेडी फ्लो प्रोसेस इज वैलिड फॉर. Now, this is generally valid for a reversible adiabatic process. We have already discussed this when we were discussing in the lectures. Now, 147. The 147 is a key concept is analyzing the filling of an evacuated tank is. Now, we have already seen that the correct option would be option number B. That is the enthalpy across the valve is remaining constant. Now the next we have the match the column type and the answer is very very simple. Okay, first let us do for A. For turbine we have work done that is H1 minus H2. For compressor it would be H2 minus H1. For compressor that is D it would be H2 minus H1. मतलब final enthalpy ज़्यादा होती है initial enthalpy से. तो A आ गया हमारा 4. तो एक ही ऑप्शन आ गया दैट इज हमारा 148 का हो गया ए. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वी हैव इफ द स्टीम इज थ्रॉटल्ड सो इन द थ्रॉटलिंग प्रोसेस अ प्रेशर एंड द एंथैल्पी रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड टेम्परेचर एंड एंट्रोपी रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड एंथैल्पी रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड बट द अदर प्रॉपर्टीज चेंज एंथैल्पी रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड बट द प्रेशर मे और मे नॉट चेंज. तो अगर एट क्वेश्चन की बात करें तो एंथैल्पी रिमेन्स अनचेंज बिकॉज थ्रॉटलिंग में एंथैल्पी कॉन्स्टेंट होता है एच कॉन्स्टेंट होता है बट दी अदर प्रॉपर्टीज मे चेंज बाकी प्रॉपर्टीज हमारी चेंज कर सकती हैं. तो ये क्वेश्चन हमारा यूपी इरिगेशन 2008 में पूछा गया था. नाउ लेट अस डू द लास्ट थ्री क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर. Which of the following expression is correct for the reversible work done by the system that is a steady flow between 1 and 2. Now the correct option would be option number B from minus 1 to 2 VDP. Now compressed air coming out from the punctured football. Now compressed air coming out from the punctured football would be nothing but it would be coming out from the punctured फुटबॉल इट इज़ डेफिनेटली बिकमिंग कूलर बिकॉज क्या हो जाता है उस केस में हमारी जो हीट जो एयर आ रही होती है वो अपनी हीट एक्सचेंज कर लेती है बहुत जल्दी और वो कूल अप हो जाती है. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वर्क आउटर फ्रॉम अ सिस्टम इज एट द एक्सपेंस ऑफ इंटरनल एनर्जी इन अ नॉन फ्लो प्रोसेस कैरिड आउट एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम कॉन्स्टेंट मतलब एडियाबैटिकली और पॉलीट्रॉपिकली. तो अगर इस क्वेश्चन की बात करें तो यहाँ पर हमारा जो वर्क आउटपुट फ्रॉम अ सिस्टम इज एट द एक्सपेंस ऑफ इंटरनल एनर्जी इज अ नॉन फ्लो प्रोसेस इट इज कैरिड आउट एट डेफिनेटली एडियाबैटिकली एडियाबैटिक कंडीशन में ऐसा हमारा पॉसिबल है. So with this we come to the end of this particular lecture. In the next lecture we shall be continuing from here onwards and we shall be solving problem number 153. So thank you so much.